Welcome to the Sports Car Club of America Demo Day at the Simeone Automotive Museum in Philadelphia. This Demo Day celebrated the cars of the 50s that ran in the Sports Car Club of America in the United States. At the time, the Sports Car Club of America only consisted of non-professional racing. The four museum cars featured were the Jaguar C-Type, Allard J2, Mercedes 300 SL Gullwing, and Cunningham C4R. The Jaguar C-Type was a racing derivative of the impressive road-going XK120. The car featured a 3.4-liter inline-six engine making about 200 horsepower. According to the museum website, disc brakes were first introduced to racing with the C-Type. The combination of lightweight, sufficient power for its time, and an aerodynamic Malcolm Sayer-designed body helped make the C-Type very successful. C-Types won the 24 Hours of Le Mans overall in 1951 and in 1953. The relatively unusual color of the museum's C-Type definitely helps to show off the wonderful design. This particular C-Type, XKC010, came third overall at the 1953 12 Hours of Sebring. The car that came in first at that race was the sister car to the next featured car of the day, the Cunningham C4R. Only three C4Rs were built by the company of the fascinating Briggs Cunningham. The United States racing colors of white with blue stripes originated with Cunningham's race cars. The C4R used a 5.4-liter Chrysler V8 engine with about 300 horsepower. Rudolf Uhlenhaut, the Mercedes designer responsible for many variants of the 300 SL, apparently said that the C4R was the safest handling car he had ever driven. This particular C4R, chassis 5217, was one of just two C4R roadsters. At the 1954 24 Hours of Le Mans, it came in third overall, but first in its class, behind the winning Ferrari 375 and a Jaguar D-Type. Its massive hood bulge, protruding oil cooler, classic livery, and incredible sound clearly tell you that it's a serious, serious race car. The third car of the day shares colors and cubic capacity with the Cunningham, but it is a very different car. The Allard J2 typically used either a 5.4-liter V8 Cadillac or a Chrysler engine, with the Cadillac making about 160 horsepower. Not unlike the Shelby Cobras of the 60s, Sidney Allard used a recipe of a large American V8 in a small and light British sports car. The best result for the J2 was third overall at Le Mans in 1950, with Sidney Allard driving his own car, finishing behind two Talbot Lagos. The fourth car is one familiar to most enthusiasts, the timeless Mercedes 300 SL Gullwing. Considered by many to be the first supercar, the 300 SL Gullwing was a street version of the 300 SL race car. The 300 SL had a 3-liter inline-six engine producing about 215 horsepower. The Gullwing doors come from the fact that the chassis comes up very high on the sides. One feature that Dr. Simeone pointed out were the hood bulges. The inline-six engine is mounted slightly less than vertical in order to keep the hood line low. The angle caused a need for a raised area of the hood on one side. Not wanting to have an asymmetrical design, a bulge was added on the other side. This particular car has one of the best stories of all the cars at the museum. It was bought by Dr. Simeone's father from a used car lot in a working-class neighborhood of Philadelphia for $4,750 in 1970. Which equates to about $30,000 today. Dr. Simeone said that he had one upped his father. The reason? Dr. Simeone's father paid $1,250 more than he had paid for a silver Gullwing a few months prior. The black car has its original paint and upholstery, according to the museum website. Now, enjoy the sights and sounds of these great 1950s race and sports cars as they are driven by Dr. Simeone and curator Kevin Kelly. If you've never visited the Simeone Museum or haven't visited in a while, I always highly recommend you visit. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos from the Simeone Automotive Museum in Philadelphia. Thank you for watching.